Hello viewers and listeners, welcome to another lesson in the area of social and environmental studies. My name is Bakari MC Sane. Now before we start our today's lesson, we need to do our correction on the past lesson entitled Historical Relics, Monuments, and Emblems in the Gambia. Now, in that lesson, we've discussed the definitions of relic, emblem, and monument, and we went further to give examples of relic, monument, and emblem in the Gambia and the importance of Katikali crocodile pool in Bakau of the Kanifi municipality was also discussed. Now, let's do our correction now. Question number one reads, what animal do people worship in Bakau Katikali? What animal do people worship in Bakau Katikali? Now, if this question is to carry 5 marks and a student or a candidate wrote bamboo as the answer. Bamboo, B-A-M-B-O. Now, should that student or candidate be given 5 marks? No. The mark that the student should be given should be 0. And the reason is because bamboo is a local word in use in the Mandinka language. So in any question whose answer is available in the English language, try as much as possible to write the English word in order to get more marks. So writing bamboo here as your answer is not correct. The correct answer here is crocodile. The animal that people worship in Bakau Katikali is called the crocodile. Okay, question number two reads, Fort Bulen was built by Commodore Charles Bulen in A. Barra, B. SL, C. Kerpate, D. Medina Serinmas. So the correct answer to this question is A, that is Barra. Now, question three reads, he was a British explorer and missionary. His obelisk is located at Same Karantaba Tenda. The above description refers to Mungo Park. Yes, the above description refers to Mungo Park. And in a situation where the student or candidate wrote Mungo Park, M-A-N-G-O, M-A-N-G-O, followed by Park, P-A-R-K. If the question carries 4 marks, for example, you will not get the full 4 marks. Yes, and the reason is the first word is wrong, Mungo, M-A-N-G-O. So it should be M-U-N-G-O, Mungo, Mungo Park. Question four reads, Fort Bulen was built by the British to, that is a phrase. So you need to complete it with a word or words in order to make it a complete sentence. So Fort Bulen was built by the British to stop the slave trade. stop the slave trade. Or you say Fort Bullen was built by the British to strengthen their positions. Now our today's lesson is entitled Longitude and Time. If you could fully remember, in one of the lessons we've talked about latitude and longitude. We said lines of latitude and longitude are used to locate places on the Earth's surface. Equally, lines of longitude are also used to calculate the time differences between places. So today we come to that lesson. Now, longitude and time is based on the fact that the planet Earth is a sphere. Now, what is a sphere? A sphere is a circular shape. A sphere is a circular shape, a shape which took the form of a circle. Now, what is a circle? It's a rounded shape. It's a rounded shape. And the total number of degrees of the planet Earth is 360 degrees. 360 degrees, which of course is the total degree to a full circle. And completes one rotation in 24 hours. So when that rotation is completed in 24 hours, that is equal to a day. That is one day. Now, a complete rotation of the Earth, which is 360 degrees, is equal to 24 hours. And 24 hours is equal to one day. Now, moving west of meridian, we subtract time. And east of meridian, we add time. This is because places in the east see the sun earlier than places in the west. I repeat, moving west of meridian, we subtract time. And east of meridian, we add time. And the reason is because places in the east see the sun earlier than places in the west. So in other words, all the places situated along the east of the Greenwich Meridian sees the sun rise before the places in the west of the Greenwich Meridian. What is this Greenwich Meridian? If you could fully remember, we say it is the most important line of longitude. Now, on the side of the latitude, we said the most important line is the equator, which is marked 0 degrees. Now, to find out the longitude and time of a given place, we need to follow these steps. To find out the longitude and time of a given place, we need to follow these steps. So these steps is a formula. You remember a formula in mathematics. Any question which requires a formula, if you can't remember that formula, now solving that question wouldn't be easy. So the same applied here. The same applies here. Work out the difference in degrees. Work out the difference in degrees. Now, after working out the difference in degrees, next, multiply the results by 4. When you multiply the results by 4, the answer will be in minutes. Now, how do we get this 4? Is that 1 degree is equal to 4 minutes. 1 degree is equal to 4 minutes. Now, how many degrees will be equal to 1 hour? That is 15 degrees. If you multiply 15 by 4, you will be, if you multiply 15 by 4, you will get 60. And how many minutes is contained in an hour? That is 60 minutes. Now, step three reads, divide the total by 60. Divide the total by 60, and then after dividing, you change it into hours. You change it into hours because the time of places has to do with hours. And how many hours is contained in a time calculation, that is 24 hours. Now the next step reads, look for the direction of the place. Look for the direction of the place. Is the direction found along the west of the Greenwich Meridian, or is it found along the east of the Greenwich Meridian? Now, if the place whose time is being calculated is found along the east of the Greenwich Meridian, you add. Why do you add? Remember, we said places in the east usually see the sun rise. In other words, this is because the sun rises in the east first, followed by the west. Now, if the place is situated along the west, you subtract. Yes. Why do you subtract? It's because places in the west received sunlight after. Yes. In other words, places in the east gain time, whilst places in the west will be losing time. Now, this is a summary of the formula. It takes the earth 24 hours to rotate 360 degrees. 1 hour to rotate 15 degrees. 4 minutes to rotate 1 degree. Now, this brings us to our first example. You remember the steps that we read? We said work out the difference in degrees, multiply the results by 4, and the answer will be in minutes. Then divide the total by 60 after changing it into hours. And then look for the direction of the place. And when it comes to the calculation of time differences, here we are sticking to only the east and west. The reason is because these two directions is where the sun rises and sets. It rises in the east and sets in the west. Now, we said it takes the earth 24 hours to rotate 360 degrees, 1 hour to rotate 15 degrees, and 4 minutes to rotate 1 degree. So now, we come to example number one. Time in Lusaka, 0 degree, is 5 o'clock p.m. What is the time in Monrovia, 30 degrees east? Now, where is this Lusaka situated? Lusaka is found in Zambia, whilst Monrovia is found in Liberia. So in other words, Lusaka is the capital city of Zambia, and Monrovia is the capital city of Liberia. Now, if you fully remember the steps, we say the first step, calculate the differences between the two places. Lusaka is on longitude 0 degree, and Monrovia is on longitude 30 degrees. So the difference here will be 30 degrees minus 0. If you subtract 0 from 30, we will still be left with 30. So you write 30 degrees. Step two, 30 degrees multiply by 4. 30 degrees multiply by 4. That will be 120 minutes. Why 120 minutes? It's because 4 times 0 will be 0, and 4 times 3 will be 12. So here we got a total of 120 minutes. Then in step 3, 120 minutes divided by 60 minutes. Why 60? Because there are 60 minutes in an hour. Now, when you divide 120 minutes by 60, you will get 2. So that 2, you write hours beside it. Then step 4, write the time in Lusaka. The time in Lusaka was 5 o'clock p.m. So now, 5 o'clock p.m., when you add 2 hours to that, you will get 7 o'clock p.m. So therefore, the time in Monrovia, 30 degrees east, will be 7 o'clock p.m. It's going to be 7 o'clock p.m. Now, example number 2. Time in Baban, 0 degree is 1400 hours. What is the time in Bangui, 15 degrees west? Now, here are the names of 2 cities in the continent of Africa. Now, Mbaban is the capital of Swaziland. Then, Bangui is the capital of the Central African Republic. Now, Mbaban is on longitude 0 degree, while Bangui is on longitude 15 degrees. So follow the steps as usual. Step 1, the difference in degree, 15 minus the 0. As you can see, 15 degrees minus 0 degree still will be left with 15 degree. Then step 2, 15 degrees times 4 minutes. Why 4 minutes? It's because 1 degree is equal to 4 minutes. And 15 multiplied by 4 gives you 60 minutes. Why 60 minutes? Because 4 times 5 is 20. Write your 0 and carry 2. 4 times 1 is 4. 4 plus 2 gives you 6. That's 60 minutes. Then step 3, 60 minutes, you divide it by 60 minutes again. Why 60 minutes? Why dividing by 60 minutes? Remember we said there are 60 minutes in an hour when it comes to time calculation. Or when it comes to time, there are 60 minutes. Now, step 4, 1400 hours. Where do we get this 1400 hours? That was the time in Mbaban, Swaziland. So the time in Swaziland, 1400 hours in Mbaban, that is to be written in step 4, as you can see, 1400 hours minus 1 hour. When you subtract 1 hour from 1400 hours, you'll be left with 1300 hours. So 1300 hours is in a form of time called GMT. GMT. So when that is changed to the local time, that is the same as 1 o'clock p.m. 1 o'clock p.m. Now, this brings us to the explanation of some of the abbreviations we made mention during this lesson. Now, a.m., 5 o'clock a.m., 2 o'clock a.m., 1 o'clock a.m., 7 o'clock a.m. So what do we mean by the abbreviation a.m.? Yes, so a.m. stands for anti-meridime, anti-meridime. Meaning, what is the meaning of anti-meridime? It means in the morning or after midnight. In the morning or after midnight. Now, sometimes you may ask your friend, what says your time? Your friend tells you it is 7 o'clock p.m. or it is 7:15 p.m. So p.m. on the other hand meant post-meridime, post-meridime. So what is the meaning of post-meridime? It means in the afternoon, in the evening, or before midnight. Once again, what is the meaning of PM? It means post meridiem, and it means in the afternoon, in the evening, or before midnight. Now, during the beginning of our lesson, we've also talked about GMT. GMT is also associated with longitude and time. When it comes to time calculation, GMT is always mentioned. So GMT refers to Greenwich Mean Time. Now, Greenwich is a name of a place in London. Greenwich is a name of a place in London, which usually determines the time differences between places. And one of their observatory stations is also situated in Accra, which is the capital city of Ghana. This brings us to our exercises. Now, question number one reads, time in Soweto, 0 degrees, is 4 o'clock p.m. Tuesday. Now, what is the time in Malabo, 15 degrees west? Now, if you remember, we've been talking about or mentioning names of cities in the continent of Africa. Now, we are still looking at it again in our exercises. Soweto is among the cities in South Africa, whilst Malabo is the capital city of Equatorial Guinea. Malabo is the capital city of Equatorial Guinea, which is also a country in the continent of Africa. Time in Nairobi, 15 degrees east, is 1:30 p.m. Now, what is the time in Tripoli, 45 degrees east? Now, I'm giving you 2 minutes to write the questions. You work them on your own before we come to the exercises. Okay, now, in answering question number one, we need to follow the steps that was discussed at the beginning of the lesson. Yes, if we follow those steps, obviously we will get to the right answer. And the same applies to question number two. We follow the same steps in order to reach to the correct answer. Now, time in Soweto, 0 degrees, is 4:30 p.m. Tuesday. What is the time in Malabo, 15 degrees west? Time in Soweto, 0 degrees, is 4:30 p.m. Tuesday. What is the time in Malabo, 15 degrees west? Now, to answer this question, say step one, you calculate the difference in degree. And the difference in degree here is 15 degrees and 0 degrees. 15 degrees and 0 degrees. So step one, say 15 degrees minus 0 degrees. Now, this will be 5 and 1. We will still be left with 15. Then step two, we said in step two, we said you multiply the difference in degree by 4 minutes, because 1 degree is equal to 4 minutes. Now, 15 multiplied by 4. 4 times 5 is 20. Write 0 and carry 2. 4 times 1 is 4. 4 plus 2, 6. So here we got 60 minutes. We got 60 minutes. Even though we got 60 minutes here, doesn't mean we will stop there. No. Yes. Even you reach at 60 minutes, you haven't exhausted the steps. So go to step 3, then you go to step 4. Step 4 is where you will reach your answer. Now, step 3, now 60 minutes that we got in step 2, write it this way, 60 in short minutes divided by 60 minutes. Why dividing it by 60 minutes is because 60 minutes make an hour. Divided by 60. Now, 0 cancels 0. 6 goes 1 into 6, 1. So, how many hours do we have here? When you divide 60 by 60, your answer will now be in hour. So, therefore, here we got 1 hour. If you want, you write HR in short. 1 hour, HR, or in full, HOUR. But to save time, if it is in an examination situation or in a test, just shorten it, write HR. Now, step 4, okay, you are going to write the time in the city of Soweto, which was 4:30 p.m. 4:30 p.m. 4:30 p.m. And what was the time differences between Soweto and Malabo? It was 1 hour according to our question. So write 1 hour below the 4:30 like this, and then HR meaning hour, then draw your two lines. Now, where is Malabo situated? Malabo, according to the question, is on longitude 15 degrees west. We say when it is west of the Greenwich Meridian, you are to subtract. And the reason is because the sun rises in the east first, followed by the west. So therefore, all the places situated along the east of the Greenwich Meridian gains time, and then all the places situated along the west of the Greenwich Meridian will be losing time. In other terms, here we are going to subtract because Malabo is on longitude 15 degrees west. 0 minus 0, you have 0. 0, you subtract from 3, you'll be left with 3. Then bring down your two dots like this way. Now, 1, you subtract it from 4, you will be left with 3. 4 minus 1. 4 minus 1, you will be left with 3. So, what is the time in Malabo now, which was on longitude 15 degrees west? The time will be 3:30 p.m. 3:30 p.m. 3:30 p.m. on Tuesday, the same Tuesday, because it's just 1 hour difference. It's just 1 hour difference between them. When it is 4:30 p.m. on Tuesday in Soweto, the time in Malabo will be 3:30 p.m. on the same Tuesday. The reason is because there is a difference of 1. Now, we come to the next question. The next question reads, time in Nairobi, 15 degrees east, is 1:30 p.m. What is the time in Tripoli, 45 degrees east? So this is the way to work. Follow the same steps like we've seen here. We follow the same steps like we are seeing here. Step 1, 2, 3, and 4. Now, as we can see, Nairobi is on 15 degrees east and Tripoli is on 45 degrees east. Follow the same steps like we did here. Okay, question 2 reads, time in Nairobi 15 degrees east is 1:30 p.m. What is the time in Tripoli 45 degrees east? Now, we write number 1, the time, the difference in degree between 45 degrees and 15 degrees. Now, 45 minus 15, 45 degrees, you subtract 15 degrees from the 45 degrees. 5 minus 5, that's 0. 4 minus 1, we'll be left with 3. Now, how many degrees are we left with? 30 degrees. Then step 2, you are going to multiply your 30 degrees by 4. The reason is because 1 degree is equal to 4 minutes. 4 times 0 is 0. 4 times 3 is 12. Now you can see, how many minutes did we got here? How many minutes? 120 minutes. You remember the other one, we got 60 minutes. But I said, even you got 60 minutes, you still divide it by 60. Yes. Don't just think that because there are 60 minutes in an hour and you stop at step 2. If you stop at step 2, you will not get to the answer. Yes. And the full mark to the question will not be awarded. Now, 120 minutes now in step 3, you are going to divide it by 60 minutes. You are going to divide it by 60 minutes. Now, 0 cancels 0. Now, 6 goes 1 into 12 is 2 times. 6 goes into 12, that is 2 times. So, how many hours did we receive here? Or we got how many hours here? Is 2 hours. In short, write it this way, 2 hrs. Then in step 4, you are going to write the time in Nairobi, which was 1:30 p.m. 1:30 p.m. 1:30 p.m. was the time in Nairobi, and what was the time difference between Nairobi and Tripoli? Now, there was a time difference of how many hours? 2 hours. So now, the 2 hours, you are going to write it below this way, 2:hrs. Meaning hours. Then draw your 2 lines. Now when you draw your 2 lines, you look at the location of Tripoli. Say Tripoli is on 45 degrees east. Now this time around, are we going to subtract? No, we are not going to subtract. And the reason is because Tripoli is on 45 degrees east. It is on 45 degrees east of the Greenwich Meridian. Therefore, time will be gained. So, when the time is gained, we are going to add. Now, we are going to add. So, therefore, write your plus sign here. Always remember, when subtracting, you write your minus sign. When adding, you write your plus sign. Now, 0 plus 0, you have 0. 0 plus 3, that's 3. Bring your 2 dots. 2 plus 1 gives us 3. So now the time in Tripoli will now be 3:30 p.m., 3:30 p.m., which, if you could fully remember, we say p.m. means post-Mary time. In short, in the afternoon. Yes, in the afternoon or in the evening. Yeah, so viewers and listeners, this brings us to the end of our today's lesson. But before we call it a day, here is your assignment. And question number one reads, time in Libreville, 0 degrees, is 5 o'clock p.m. Libreville is the capital of Gabon. What is the time in Cape Town, 30 degrees east? Cape Town is in South Africa. Now, the option reads 1 o'clock p.m., 7 o'clock p.m., 6 o'clock p.m., and 3 o'clock p.m. Question number two reads, time in Lomé, 0 degrees is 1400 hours. Lomé is the capital city of Togo. Now, what is the time in Banjul, 15 degrees west? Banjul is the capital city of the Gambia. And the options read 1500 hours, option A, option B, 1300 hours, and option C, 1700 hours, whilst option D is 1900 hours. Viewers and listeners, this brings us to the end of our today's lesson. Before we call it a day, let's remember the presence of COVID-19 in our midst. So please adhere to the health safety standards of the Ministry of Health as well as the World Health Organization of the United Nations for our own safety and security. Thank you.